Have you guys heard of shockwaves for erectile dysfunction? Well, finally, I am making the video you have all been asking me for about shockwaves for erectile dysfunction. I'm Dr. Rena Malik, urologist and pelvic surgeon. And if you're new here, we talk all about urology here, sexual health, bladder health, and much, much more. Make sure you subscribe so you can see my new videos each and every week. So what exactly is shockwaves for erectile dysfunction and how does it work? Well, shockwave therapy's long form is actually low-intensity extracorporeal shockwave therapy. And in this video, we're going to go through a few things. We're going to go through, one, exactly how this works to improve erections, what is the data about shockwave therapy, and who does it work best for? And number three, what do the American and European guidelines say about shockwave therapy? And lastly, how to know if you're getting the right treatment. So how does it actually work? Well, shockwave therapy actually produces these acoustic waves to parts of the penis that create mechanical stress. And then that area heals. And it's during that healing process where you're actually gonna see the improvement in erectile function. And the theory of this is that it actually creates more blood vessels and even potentially some nerve regrowth in the penis, so it can actually potentially reverse some of the damage to the penis. So what happens is the cells that get traumatized through the shock waves release things called vascular endothelial growth factor and fibroblast growth factor. And these factors are really important in the formation of blood vessels. And clinically, if you're making more blood vessels, you should be getting more blood flow. And you're getting more blood flow, well, then you're getting better erections. There's actually some data that suggests in animal models that healing from shockwave therapy releases neutrophilic growth factors, which means that it can potentially cause some nerve regeneration and may be useful for patients who have nerve injury. However, we don't have enough data on this yet. So what data do we know about shockwave therapy? Well, we have what's called meta-analyses. And meta-analyses are studies that look at all the data that's been done and looked at for shockwave therapy. And it combines all the data together to see, does shockwave therapy actually work? So let's get into it. There's two meta-analyses that I'm going to go over. The first one looked at only randomized controlled trials. And what does that mean? That means that you have patients who either get the shockwave therapy or patients who don't get the shockwave therapy but think they're getting it, or a placebo. And then they're compared. And this is kind of the best or gold standard of investigations for trials in patients, because we can really see the difference. Is it placebo effect? Do you think you're going to get better erections? So maybe that helps with some of your function, versus is it because of the actual treatment itself? These specific studies looked at people who had organic erectile dysfunction, specifically due to most often vascular causes. And that's for the large majority of people, due to high blood pressure, diabetes, and other sort of medical problems that can affect blood flow to the penis. It did not include people who got radiation that caused erectile dysfunction, or people who had chronic pelvic pain that was associated with their erectile function. So in this meta-analysis, they included 7 studies over 5 different countries, and they didn't have a uniform protocol. So they varied the type of shockwave generator, they varied the number of shockwaves that were given, and how many locations they included on the penis itself to target during the shockwave. So shockwave generators come in 3 different flavors. They can come in electromagnetic, electrohydraulic, or piezoelectric. And so they all create these focused shockwaves, which can get into a certain depth of penetration that is deep enough to penetrate the deep tissues of the penis, that can create new vessels and potentially new nerves in the penis. The most common protocol was getting 6 weeks of treatments with 12 treatments. Usually it was 3 weeks where you got 6 treatments, then a 3-week break, and then another 3 weeks of treatments. However, that wasn't consistent across all studies. And basically how they evaluated erectile function was by using specific questionnaires that are given to patients that are used as a validated questionnaire to identify the degree of erectile dysfunction. And what they found was that there was a statistically significant improvement in erectile function at 1 month after getting treatment with shockwave therapy. So 1 month is not a really long time. What have other studies shown us? Well, another meta-analysis looked at a wider number of trials. So they included both the randomized controlled trials trials as well as cohort studies where they took a bunch of people and they gave them shockwave therapy and they followed them over time. And the difference between this meta-analysis and the other one was not just that, but they also included patients who had Peyronie's disease or curvature of the penis. If you want to learn more about that, make sure you check out my last video on Peyronie's disease. And they also included patients with pain disorders that can also impact erectile function. So based on this data, what are the urologic associations that kind of govern our clinical care saying? So the American Urological Association updated its guidelines in 2018. And what they say is that shockwave therapy should be considered investigational and not be given as a routine treatment for erectile function based on the limitations that we see in the data, and some of which I've discussed previously. Interestingly, the European Association guidelines were just updated in September of 2021. And what they recommend is that it may be offered to men who have vasculogenic erectile dysfunction, but these men should be fully counseled before treatment. Where does this counseling come in? So who is shockwave therapy best for? Well, shockwave therapy is best for men who have mild erectile dysfunction. And mild erectile dysfunction is men who either don't require oral medications yet or are doing well with oral medications, or maybe they've been on oral medications and they've just recently stopped responding to those medications. So those people are really a great candidate for shockwave lithotripsy based on the data that we have. There's some possibility that perhaps people who have more severe erectile dysfunction may have benefit when you're combining this with other therapies. However, the data doesn't tell us yet exactly what that might be. And I think, again, to know that this may be limited. It's only a 50 to 60% success rate at 1 year. However, the data shows that it's pretty safe. There's very few adverse events with it. So the things to consider are really how much time it takes to get through the treatments and the cost. So when we're talking about cost, how do you know that you're getting the right treatment? Well, so as I mentioned earlier, the things that you want to look for, the shockwaves that actually help, are focused shockwaves. And when you're thinking about shockwaves, there are different types of shockwaves. There's the focused shockwaves, which have the right depth of penetration and the right waveform that will create this neogenesis of blood vessels, compared to the other type of shockwave that we see often, which is a radial shockwave. And radial shockwaves are actually more superficial and don't result in any of those changes that we see with focused shockwaves. But interestingly, radial shockwave generators are much cheaper to purchase. And so a lot of the men's health clinics that suggest they're giving shockwave may be giving you radial shockwave therapy rather than focused shockwaves. And that radial therapy will not help. So the best way is to find out what exact machine they're using and does it produce focused shockwaves or not. Also, because it's still considered investigational in the United States, you can find investigators who are doing clinical trials on shockwave therapy. And that's the best way. Get involved in a clinical trial. One, you can see if it's going to work for you. And two, you can be part of the solution. Let's find out if this is a great therapy for many, many men coming down the pipeline in the future. I think there's still a lot more that we need to find out about shockwaves. We need to find out exactly what is the best treatment protocol. What about people who have erectile dysfunction from other problems like prostate surgery or nerve problems? What about those patients? And how about the long-term outcome? Is there any benefit to getting repeated treatments later down the line? And lastly, what about having individualized treatment protocols? So if someone has mild ED, maybe a less rigorous protocol would work best for them. But if someone has really severe erectile dysfunction, maybe a more aggressive or more frequent protocol may be best for them. And I think all of that is being studied, and we will know much, much more in the next years to come. And hopefully this will become a great treatment option for men with erectile function. But for now, if you're thinking about shockwave therapy, one, make sure that you know you're getting focused shockwave therapy, and two, that you realize your success rate may be variable depending on how bad your erectile dysfunction is to start. And while you may see some improvement, we don't know the long-term data at this time. Thanks so much for watching. As always, remember to take care of yourself because you're worth it.